My name is Edmond Laryea, and I've lived here on Staten Island for like the last 19 years. I used to live on Richmond Terrace, right across the street from Fable Pool, right from Fable Park. So if you guys know, I'm sure you guys know what that is. I used to live right there. So you're looking at a guy that came from the same background as you guys did. So I don't want you to look at me any differently. I'm literally on the same exact playing field as you guys. As far as your life, there's three things I want you to always keep in mind. The first thing I always want you to keep in mind, and this is what makes all of us equal. You know, obviously there's different social classes, a lot of different things about us, you know, the way we look, the way we dress and all that stuff. But the three things that I think, in my opinion, I feel like we all have in common is, number one is creativity, our mind, the ability to be creative, the ability to have a vision, believe in yourself. That's the first thing that I think we all have in common. The second thing that we all have in common is heart. We all have a heart. We all have a beating heart. We all passionate about something. We all have things that we care about. So that's what I want you guys to really think about. And the third thing is 24 hours. I don't care who you are. I don't care what part of the world you live in. I don't care what your background is, if black, white, no matter the case, you got 24 hours. So you decide what you're gonna do this 24 hours. All right, so those are the three things I want you to think about life. All right, if you're really trying to get to what it is you're trying to get to, a lot of you guys are young, so you probably don't have a clear-cut idea of what it is that you want yet. But those three things are the same for everybody. So I never really want to hear an excuse about life when you have those three things. As far as school goes, there's three things I want you to apply while you're here at school. And first thing I want you guys to really think about is respect. All right, respect. You guys got to respect each other, your peers, teachers, guidance counselors, principal, the people in your community. Like, I really want you guys to have respect. That's one of those things that people take for granted nowadays, especially in our generation. Like, people take that for granted. You got to have respect. All right. Second thing I want you guys to think about while you're here in school is hard work. That's the most cliche word I've heard over the course of my life, but that's the thing that got me to this point is hard work. And the last thing I want to talk to you guys about is sacrifice. Now, no matter who it is, if you ever want to get to like a certain level or you want to get to a certain goal, you ask any of the teachers in here how hard it is to be a teacher, or how hard it is to be a principal, how hard it is to be a police officer, how hard it is to be a firefighter, work on television, you know, be a doctor. That stuff is hard. In order for you to get to those levels, you want to be a football coach, you want to be a football player, you want to run track, you got to make some sacrifices. The thing that sucks about this time period that we're in is that we have social media right at our hands, so it makes everything look like it's easy to access. You got to make some sacrifices to get that. It's easy to go on social media, that's easy. But to get your dream, to get to the goal that you want to, that takes a lot of work, all right? I want to go back and just emphasize respect a little bit, because it's like a lost art. And I just want you guys to make me one promise when you leave here. If you don't take nothing else from this speech that I'm giving you guys, I want you guys to promise me that you're going to start to respect the people in your community, your peers, your teachers, principals, your family members. Let's start having respect, all right? Let's start changing the culture. Let's start having respect. So if that's one thing I can have you guys take away from all of this, it's having respect. Just a quick background on me. I went to Tottenville High School, played football for 4 years. I was fortunate enough to get a scholarship, went on to play football at Rutgers. And the theme of this week is overcoming obstacles, right? Well, when I got to college and things were going great, man, I had a really good high school career, got a scholarship, like I said, went on to play on football at Rutgers. And in 2007, my second year in, after I had a great freshman year, just like that, I blew my knee out. The one thing I was passionate about was taken away from me like this. In a second. So we all have passions, right? My passion was television. My passion was football. So back in 2007, just like this, I had my first passion, my first love taken away from me. I wasn't able to play. I was out for a whole year. All through high school, everything was good. Never got hurt. Everything was great. Had my first obstacle that I had to overcome back in 2007. Blew my knee out. For you guys that don't know, an ACL is it's a ligament in your knee that allows you to make all those explosive movements that you see on television. Now, the one thing that I was passionate about, I lost. So what it did for me was two things. One was it made me get focused about school. I was like, you know what? I need to get it together, because this football thing can end at any point. So let me get it together. So then I got really, really focused on school. But second, it gave me a fire and a drive to overcome that, overcome obstacles. Listen, a lot of you guys are going to face a lot of obstacles through your life, 14, 15. Listen, by the time you get to 30, 40, this is when there are a lot of obstacles that you face, some of them bigger than the others. But what I want you to do is you got to be able to mentally prepare yourself to overcome those obstacles. All right, so I worked my way back. I was able to get back, worked hard, do a lot of the things that I was supposed to do, rehab, twice a day at the gym for 5 days. I was able to get back. Then in 2010, when I was a senior, boom, blew my other knee out. Second ACL tear. I'm like, are you serious? I'm trying to get to the NFL, and now I got to deal with two ACL tears. So you're going to have a goal that you're going to try to get to in life, and there's going to be some obstacles that are going to try to stop you. And what you got to tell yourself is, like, I'm not going to let anything stop me. I'm going to overcome these obstacles. And that's what I did. I told myself, get focused, do what you got to do, get yourself back on the field. I was able to get myself back on the field, worked out. You guys saw a lot of the working out stuff that I do, and that's another passion of mine. And I was able to get myself to the point when, in 2013, I got a shot with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Granted, I didn't make the team, but if I would have given up in 2007, that opportunity doesn't even come around. That was a whole 6 years later. If I would have given up in 2007 when I tore my first knee, that opportunity doesn't even come around. Now, me being able to play college football, not quitting, staying on track, being able to do all those things was what helped me get to the next level, and that was my passion of being on television. There's gonna be some stuff that's gonna stop you from doing that. School, there's gonna be some stuff that's gonna stop you from doing that. There's some people out there that's gonna try to stop you from getting your education. There's gonna be some people that are gonna try to stop you from getting your education. There's gonna be situations that happen in your life that's gonna stop you, they're gonna try to stop you from getting your education. You gotta be able to overcome all of those things, all right? I'm giving you the blueprint. Like, as long as you can do those things for me, man, you're set. But who, like, how bad do you want it though? Like, are you ready? Are you ready to show respect? Are you ready to work hard? Are you ready to make some sacrifices? Are you guys ready? I'll give you some 3 life tips. I'll give you being creative, having a heart, which include passion, in 24 hours. What are you gonna do with that opportunity? Half of you guys raised your hand when I asked you who went to I-51. That means we came from the same thing. You get what I'm saying? As I wrap this thing up, and I want to be very, very clear about respect. I want to be very, very clear on that, all right? That's one thing I want you guys to promise me you're going to do moving forward. Apply those principles, utilize those principles, and I'm just looking forward to see what happens with you guys, all right? So thank you so much for allowing me to be here. Thank you so much for giving me time to speak to you guys and be able to talk to you guys.